Well, we're finally here at the concert, and we still have about half an hour till it starts. I'm here with Zach. Remember him? Melissa.
Not right now. I don't want to do too much.
Mom.
Hey, can't wait for Weird Al.
And Joey. Can't wait for this to start. Got a lot of good merchandise. I'll see you later.
With the beans blended, they're then set ahead to be roasted in large revolving roasters like this one. The roasted cocoa beans are then ready to move on to the next stage of the process, a process that will begin to transform plain cocoa beans into Hershey's milk chocolate. It begins right up ahead with a process known as breaking. With the beans now roasted, they arrive here at the breaking chamber, where the shells are shattered into tiny fragments. What's left is called the meat, the part of the beans actually used to make chocolate. The meat now passed through the milling machine, tested on the lab. This grinding process generates a smooth heat, which melts the milk into a liquid called chocolate liquid. Of course, this liquid has no alcohol content. This is the liquid from which all chocolate is made. Next, this large press machine is used to squeeze cocoa butter from the chocolate liquid. This cocoa butter will be added back later in the process to make the chocolate smooth and creamy. Well, now we come to that all-important element, milk. And who better to tell us about it than the experts themselves? Well, the gals are right. Milk is how Hershey's chocolate gets its special flavor and the extra added nutritional value. As the gals say, it's nutritious. In fact, hundreds of farms around this region and thousands of cows supply over a quarter of a million gallons of milk each and every day. We're now in central blending. It's the heart of the Hershey's chocolate making process. Here, milk, sugar, and chocolate liquor are brought together and mixed in just the right proportions to create that special Hershey's taste. As the milk and sugar is combined with cocoa, it's mixed together until it becomes a smooth blend of milk chocolate. But we're not done yet. From here, the liquid chocolate leaves the large containers in this chamber, where it will be dried once again. Yes, that's right. This liquid mixture is now conveyed to dryers, such as the one you see on your left. The dryer removes excess moisture, which results in chocolate crumbs. The machine up ahead adds cocoa butter into the mix, which transforms it into a smooth chocolate paste, ready for refining. Mmm, what's that wonderful smell? That's right. After all that shaking, breaking, baking, and flaking, we're finally coming up with Hershey's milk chocolate. But there's still a ways to go before it's finished. On your left is a series of roll refining machines. The refining process grinds the chocolate until it reaches a uniform and smooth consistency. Next, as seen on your left, the chocolate is further refined by a unique process called conching. These heavy rollers refine the chocolate for up to 72 hours until it reaches a silky, liquid texture. The material that leaves the conching process is called chocolate paste. These machines supply production lines with over 1 million pounds of chocolate paste per day. Now, after all that effort, we're finally ready to make our Hershey's chocolate bar. Here on your left, chocolate bars are leaving the molding line. They're then cooled and removed from the molds, the final step before being wrapped. And with our milk chocolate made to perfection, we then add peanuts, almonds, and other extras to create a world of wonderful chocolate treats. Here you see the completely automated wrapping machines putting the finishing touch on Hershey's world-famous chocolate and candy products. Tour wouldn't be complete without seeing our famous Hershey's Kisses. Hershey's Kisses are made by dropping a precise amount of chocolate on a moving steel gun and quickly cooling it to form the famous Hershey's Kiss Shape. We can make over 60 million Kiss Shape products every day.
Thanks for joining us here.
2016, Hershey's Chocolate Factory is a world unto itself.
Thank you.